World leaders will not be required to show proof of vaccination when they enter the UN General Assembly Hall. Dozens of heads of state and foreign ministers are due to visit the UN in New York next week for an annual high-level gathering. State officials have told the UN that under its rules, people must prove that they have vaccinated before they can enter the hall. The UN headquarters in Manhattan is international territory and not subject to US laws. But UN officials have previously pledged to abide by local and national guidelines when it comes to the pandemic.
I think we have discussed with the municipality the different ways to ensure that we have a maximum of people with vaccination. And the New York mayor's office has put a vaccination capacity at our disposal, so people that come will be able to be vaccinated in the premises or immediately outside the premises. And we hope that there will be other mechanisms. Of course, we as Secretariat cannot tell a head of state if he's not vaccinated that he cannot enter the United Nations. This also must be understood.
New York is providing COVID testing and the single-dose Johnson & Johnson vaccine at a site outside the UN headquarters next week.
Meanwhile, new research has found that some people who catch COVID-19 and are later vaccinated develop incredibly strong immunity to the virus. The details in this report.
It's being dubbed superhuman immunity. New research shows some people may have a significantly higher level of immunity to COVID-19 that could even protect them from future pandemics. Scientists studied individuals who have recovered from the virus and then later received an mRNA vaccine such as Pfizer or Moderna. What they found was that protection against a disease and its variants was higher than immunity conferred by either infection alone or vaccine alone. Paul Benash is a virologist at the Rockefeller University. He prefers the term hybrid rather than superhuman immunity.
So this is a phenomenon that we and others have uncovered in people who were infected by SARS-CoV-2 early in the pandemic. And then some months later, when vaccines became available, they were vaccinated. Their antibodies were not only capable of neutralizing all of the SARS-CoV-2 variants that we have seen thus far, they're also capable of neutralizing viruses that are very much more diverse, including the original SARS coronavirus, which is really quite different to the current ones, viruses that are currently circulating in bats and pangolins.
Benash went on to urge caution, stressing that the research is new and needs more real-world testing. He said it did offer hope, though, for the people who had recovered from the disease and been vaccinated. His team is investigating whether a third booster shot has the same effect. So far, more than 226 million people around the world have been infected with COVID, and some 4.8 million people have died. The World Health Organization has said another flu pandemic is inevitable, that it is a matter of when, not if.